I am Professor Dr. R.M. Saraogi. I was an honorary professor at St. G.S. Medical College and Dr. R.N. Cooper Hospital. I am also attached to Nanavati Hospital. I am also practicing at my own hospital called as Saraogi Maternity and General Hospital. I am attached to Cloudnine Hospital as a consultant. I am into practice since last 45 years. Cervical cancer is basically caused by HPV virus, human papilloma virus. And this is a great discovery for which a Nobel Prize was given to the concerned person. Now, since it is caused by HPV virus, it affects the cervix and the symptoms can appear early or it may take little longer time. The symptoms of cervical cancer are, there can be excessive smelly discharge. That is one of the commonest features which you can get in cervical cancer. Since cervical cancer occurs at a later age, so these ladies may be postmenopausal, coming with bleeding per vagina. Generally, we know that once menopause has occurred, you don't expect any bleeding occurring per vagina. But in the case of cervical cancer, you may come across a case of bleeding per vagina. Fishy odor can be there. Patient can come with excessive bleeding also. Periods can be heavy also. And as far as signs are concerned, it depends how early the patient has come. On examination, you may find a growth over there. You may find a lesion over there. If patient has come pretty late, she may be anemic also because of blood loss. It can affect the kidney, resulting into nephropathies and uropathies. It can go to different parts of the body, causing metastatic lesions. So diagnosis of cervical cancer at an early stage is very, very essential. And luckily for us, since we know the reason behind infection or cervical cancer occurring due to HPV virus, we have something to prevent cervical cancer now by vaccinating our young girls from the age of 10 years till the age of 38 to 40 years with HPV vaccine, where we give 2 doses or 3 doses and which protects a girl or a lady from cervical cancers.